In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Deacon Angel Palacios from the Mission of St. Andrew in Tijuana, Baja California, Diocese of Mexico, of the Orthodox Church in America. The Gospel is for February the 3rd, 2019, according to St. Luke. The foreigner is more obedient than the false Israel. Jesus began speaking in the synagogue, saying, "Today this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." And all spoke highly of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They also asked, "Isn't this the son of Joseph?" He said to them, "Surely you will quote me this proverb, 'Physician, cure yourself,' and say, 'Do here in your native place the things that we heard were done in Capernaum.'" And he said, "Amen, I say to you, no prophet is accepted in his own native place. Indeed, I tell you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the sky was closed for 3.5 years, and a severe famine spread over the entire land. It was to none of these that Elijah was sent, but only to the widow in Sarepta, in the land of Sidon. Again, there were many lepers in Israel during the time of Elisha the prophet, yet no one of them was cleansed but only Naaman the Syrian." When the people in the synagogue heard this, they were all filled with fury. They rose up, drove him out of the town, and led him to the brow of the hill on which their town had been built, to hurl him down headlong. But Jesus passed through the midst of them and went away. Glory be to thee, O God, glory be to thee. As I said, what I would like to preach about you is obedience. Seems like the Lord went right there, smack in the face, to tell them about something that is very, very important when he says that no prophet is accepted in his native place. What is it that he is asking of them, what he is recriminating of them and of all of us, the false Israel? Well, that they are disobedient, that they do not want to hear and heed. They just want, we all want to receive miracles and marvels, but we don't want to comply with God, with God's will. Let us examine, just for a brief period of time, these two recipients of miracles, recipients of the mercy of God. The first one was a sinner, just as you and me. He was a general, the star general of the Syrian army, but he was afflicted with leprosy. And because he owned an Israelite slave, she told him that he should go and ask the God of the Israelites to be cleansed. And mistakenly thinking that the king of Israel would be able to intercede for him, he goes along to his own king, receives letters of commendation for the king of Israel, and then grabs a lot of presents to present the king of Israel and sets about to meet the king of Israel. When the king of Israel reads, not knowing God, he is very upset. He says he is trying to start war. Who am I, God, to grant him his cleansing? Thank God God provided that this general would meet Elisha. But Elisha did not consent to meeting him. He just gave word that he ought to go down to the Jordan and bathe himself 7 times. And back the general went very, very upset, furious, when one of his slaves told him, "Sir, if the prophet had told you to do something really difficult, undoubtedly you would have done it. But he only told you to cleanse yourself 7 times. Why don't you do it?" And he becomes humble. He humbles himself to cleanse himself in the Jordan. What does that mean? Well, basically what it means is that he accepted baptism. But it basically also means that he is being obedient to God, and he receives the cleansing of all his person, contrary to the false Israelites. And then how about the widow? Let us remember that in the time of Elijah, there was this great famine. And when Elijah, hungry, approaches that widow in Sarepta, he asks her, "Please prepare something for me to eat." And she answers back, by your God. She was a pagan. I tell you that I came to grab a little bit of wood to prepare the last of our bread, so for my children and I to eat it and then wait for death. That was the last. But she believed Elijah, because Elijah said, so says the Lord, it will not diminish until there is rain. And it happened like that. But she believed her. She risked everything she had. Again, we have to be obedient. Otherwise, it is not enough to say, well, God is merciful. Okay, He is merciful. If you don't want to be cleansed, if you don't want to be obedient, you will not be saved. That is precisely the sin against the Holy Spirit. Not being willing to believe and trust. May the Lord, who is merciful, grant His face, His shining face, on the hearts of every one of us.